Hello all, welcome back to my channel Hithika Productions. I hope everyone is doing good. So guys, today I'm going to show you how we can do the installation of A360 on-prem. So if you seen my previous two videos, there I explained how we can provision a VM machine or RDP machine for on-prem setup. And also in my previous tutorial, I explained about how we can do the setup of SQL Server 2019, right? So guys, if you are visiting my channel first time, do subscribe and hit on bell icon so that whenever I upload new videos, you will get the notification. So let's move on. Let's see how we can do the installation, and let's see what are the challenges we are going to face. So as I mentioned previously in my previous video, here is my Azure. So if you can see, there are I think yesterday the the credits were I think 14,200. Now it is dropped almost 19 credits because of the things which I used yesterday. So if you wanted to go with these installations, even you can use these mini credits, and later you can stop it. If you don't wanted to pay anything, you can once these credits were expired, you can stop using it. By till the time you can install A360 on-prem, and you can explore on more admin related activities in control room, or installation related activities, whatever you wish to do. You can work on ARI or whatever it is, until your 14,200 credits are expired, you can use it with free of cost. Later also, if you wanted to use, you can upgrade it to pay as you go, so that whatever the time you are going to use, it is going to be charged from your payment method which you mentioned when you are registered. Okay, let's move on. I'm just going to start my virtual machine. So make sure when you are not using it, make sure you just stopped it so that it is not charged. If it is in running state, then ultimately this is charged from your payment method. Okay, it is starting. Let's go back just to refresh. So I can see it is running. So here is my host. Yeah, the same one. I'm just connecting to it. Okay. So previously, I have downloaded the A360 software from A People website, and the latest version, which is currently, was 20.23. So initially, it takes some time to start the services. Okay, let me go to downloads. Here is my, let me cross check, wants to start, wants to log into DB to make sure which is running. So guys, I'm going to keep pause video for some time if I feel the installation is going to take longer time, but I will keep all the major things in the video. I don't miss any step, but if it takes a step to step some time, then I will try to pause the recording of the video. Okay, let's go ahead. I can see this. Let me go with the application. So it is preparing to install. Maybe I'm expecting this might throw an error saying prerequisite sites are not fulfilled. Let's see if we can push forceful installation. If it is not going to happen, then I may need to upgrade my what I can say. Okay, as you go. Yeah, it is throwing. So if it is, if it throw error, I will change my subscription. I will provision for as per the recommendation. So this is what available, and this is the expectation. Nothing was met except OS. Let's see if we can go with kind of a forceful installation. Even though there is no prerequisites, will it going to be installed or not? If it installed, then it would be fine. On-prem, let's go. Accept the license terms. Okay. I'll go with Express. Maybe we might get some issues to connect it to the database. So I was just given this Automationanywhere A360 database. Okay. Here is the thing which I'm expecting should fail or throw error, so that we can enable few things. Yeah, just is failing. Okay, so if we this is the expected thing, so we'll tell you what to do. SQL configuration manager, let's go here. There you can see, let's go to services. There we can see both, right? One is SQL Express and another one is agent. This is running. Let's try starting the stop this. Okay, so let me make it log on as built-in account, and this is local system. Some time, and this is okay. And bot agent, let me try starting this, changing the properties. This may throw an error, okay, which is disabled. Yeah, let's go here and enable it. Now let's go back, local system, apply. Not sure why this is throwing error. Okay, let me do it for local system. Since I'm referring to Windows authentication, so I need to do these things. And then you go to protocols, you can see TCP/IP, everything is enabled. Let's go to TCP/IP. Okay, everything is fine. Now go to server network. This is the thing. Here, these things were disabled. Let me enable them. I hope this will resolve the issue. If not, we may need to restart it. Let's go to IP addresses and then. this will resolve. Let's see. Will it going to solve it or will it going to throw some errors? Okay. If this fails, let's start with custom, and we'll see. When we selected custom, it asks you to select the database server name also. The time it helps. By default, we stopped the SQL Server Express and we just enabled the dev. Let's go back. Let's go with custom. Nothing. We are not using CyberArk or something. Okay. Not using any HTTP related. Local system account. Okay. So here is the thing. Let me see if it can do something. Okay. Is running well. Let me try the SQL first, we'll see. No, this is not going to work since it is in stop state. Restart of it. Let's try our luck. Yeah, it is accepted. So the only change which I made was I just enabled allow services to interact with the desktop. I just enabled this and restarted it. So it is asking Elastic password. Keep this in mind, it will be useful for future. Okay, I'm not setting up any cluster or something. So which is a single machine installation. I'm not setting it up in HA mode, high availability mode to configure network load balance. This will go. Let's see how it goes. So meanwhile, guys, if you guys have any questions or do you want me to make some videos on some specific topics, you can comment on the videos or you can drop it on to this email ID. Even if you have questions on real-time use cases which you are implementing in day-to-day your projects, you can drop those into this email ID. I will respond whenever I get a time. I will respond back. Even though you can comment out what are the things which you are would like me to make a tutorial and upload it in YouTube so that I can do them. See if there is something. It may take some time. I can pause it for a while for the recording, and then I will resume it back whenever it comes to the next screen. Guys, it's almost at final stage, so I just resume back the video recording. Messaging service. So once it's done, I guess it will prompt for super admin to be created. Finalizing automation with 360 services, which may take 5 minutes. I will pause it and unpause once the next screen comes. Yes, finally. Automationanywhere A360 has been installed and it is asking launch automation 360. I'm just clicking finish. It will be launched it in IE or default browser is IE, so it is going to IE. Specify the path or the shared path of the control room repository where the automation files are stored. So it is asking me to give you a path. So let me do one thing. Let me find out that the path. I'm not able to see. Let me minimize it. I'll do one thing. I will just create one RPA folder in this, or we go to Program Files Automation A360. All the things are here. I'll give here itself. And specify the host name, URL, or IP, reverse proxy, load balancer. I will just give host is 52.140.73.75.3.76.52.140. Okay. Or can I give Hithika Productions? Okay, let it go. Let's go with this. Let's go back and continue. So here is the thing. If it's my personal, so I just go ahead with, you know, what I can say, control room database. If it is organization related, they can use you know, Active Directory. So that is how usually the organizations uses. So simply they can pull the employee information from Active Directory, and they can just create the users or disable whatever it may be. So I will go with control room database. Since I don't have all other three, I'll just go with control room. Okay, I will just say super admin. This will ask, you know, the email ID. So I can give production. If you enable, you know, email server, then everything happens on this particular, you know, control room will be triggered email to it based on the alerts we are enabled. Password for you guys. Sure, why it is asking the password. Guys, I will be pause to keep the password. I will keep the pause the video. Okay. So I'm just doing click next. Questions usually. All the questions you wish to, you can keep those. Say one moment. So here we go. We got our control room ready. Got it. Okay, let me do one thing. I'll just take this URL and let's drop it from here. I'll just go to see here also it is open, right? Let me change its properties to default to. Okay, so I got it. So I'm done. So we can see all the things here, right? See automation starting was there, and we can see audit logs. We can see users, we can see roles which are available default ones, and license. Everything is the trial one. Let me get it. There is a trial. File install from file. Guys, if you can see here, everything is showing trial not purchased, right? And the default, they are showing a few things which is default. And you can see the last updated is this, and the expire is going to be 22. I'm just installing it from my file, so that it will be extended to maybe 6 months. Yeah, you can see till July, and everything is purchased. You can see now it is increased from 3 to 10. Unattended bottlenecks also 10. Attended bottlenecks is 10. And we have, let's see, IQ bots are 10,000 pages. We can do it. Discovery bots, everything. No updated, right? And here is some settings. So here is the Git integration. In the next video, I'm going to show you guys how we can do this setup, and also I will show you how we can create ourselves for testing purpose our own Git account. And this is the thing for today. I hope you get to know how we can do the installation of A360 Anthem. So guys, if you are visiting my channel first time, please do subscribe the channel and hit bell icon so that you will get notifications on my further tutorials. And And guys, as I said in my previous video, I'm going to access this particular server from my local machine. Let's see whether it is going to happen or not. Or is it required to enable some other additional securities? So I'm just doing this. For sure it throw an error. It is not able to reach to this particular. That is where I'm just trying to find out my host file. Or parallel, let's see if I can do something on here to enable the security. Properties, identity configuration. Somewhere I can see host related. Some time. I have been used it a very long time back. So unable to find where exactly things. Let's see, network, okay. Star, I will see. Port is also star. Sources and then I can give. Okay, let's give in. Source port is in this particular custom. And this is the priority. We'll just say it. Good. So that it is going to be quick. Even though I need to enable this thing. Let's see, I can keep IP address instead of complete host. Expecting we should fail. Let's go with the outbound as well. So guys, I will show you what exactly in our local machine to do to access this particular server from the server in the local machine in my next tutorial. Okay, so in the next tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can access it from the local machine and what are the changes to the host file is required. And then I will show you how the Git is going to work, how we can set up the Git. GitHub and how we can create our own GitHub account and integration with Git. Okay, I hope this video helps you to learn how to do the installation of A360 on premises, and even this helps you to sort out the issues which initial few issues which we are going to face with respect to database. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye.